Hi, everyone. Let's talk about the rules of debits and credits as introduced in Chapter 3. Chapter 3 does a pretty fair job of introducing the concept of debits and credits, but I think I'd like to add a little bit extra to hopefully clarify what the textbook is saying. In financial accounting, we will be posting a lot of business transactions by using debits and credits in T accounts and in journal entries. So it's important that you get started off with a good understanding of how to use debits and credits. First of all, I want to make it clear that in financial accounting, there is no definition for the word debit. I want you to get rid of all your preconceived ideas of what debit means. We are not talking about debit cards. We are not talking about using a debit card to purchase merchandise. In financial accounting, debit simply means that the number is posted on the left-hand side of a vertical line. If you are going to debit an account, post the number on the left side of a vertical line. And there are lots of vertical lines in our books and records for financial accounting. Credits, the same thing. There is no definition for credit. Please get rid of all your preconceived ideas of what credit might mean. Credit simply means posting a number on the right side of a vertical line. So in financial accounting, debits are posted on the left side of a vertical line, credits are posted on the right. Debits on the left, credits on the right. You can take that to the bank. It is always true in every single situation in financial accounting. Debits are on the left and credits are on the right. The rules of debits and credit that I'd like to discuss with you next is, like signs add and opposite signs subtract. A debit posting will increase a debit balance. A credit posting will increase a credit balance. While opposite signs subtract, a credit posting will decrease a debit balance, and a debit posting will decrease a credit balance. So opposite signs subtract, like signs add. Keep these rules in mind. We're going to come back to this in the next lecture. The next thing that I'd like you to be aware of in the rules of debits and credits has to do with the expanded accounting equation that we discussed in Chapter 2. Assets equals liabilities plus owner's equity plus income or revenue minus expenses minus draws. I know this is slightly in a different order than what we talked about before, but it doesn't matter. Draws reduce equity. Expenses reduce equity, income increases equity. It says the same thing that we talked about in Chapter 2. But what we didn't talk about in Chapter 2 is understanding that each category within the expanded accounting equation has been assigned a normal or expected balance. All asset accounts have a normal debit balance. All liability accounts have a credit balance. The capital account has a credit balance. Income or revenue accounts have a credit balance. Expenses have a normal debit balance, and draws have a debit balance. We'll talk briefly about this and give some examples, then we're going to practice in another video lecture for Chapter 3. Let's take an example in the asset section. An asset account cash would have a normal debit balance. All asset accounts, including cash, have debit balances. Therefore, if we want to increase the balance in cash, and we know that like signs add, cash has a normal debit balance, we would have to debit the account to increase its balance because a debit will increase a debit balance. If we need to decrease cash, we would have to credit the account because opposite signs subtract. A credit posting would reduce cash because cash has a normal debit balance and opposite signs subtract. Let's look at an example of a liability account. Accounts payable is a liability account, so it has a normal credit balance. If we receive a bill from a creditor, we will need to increase accounts payable. Accounts payable has a normal credit balance. So to increase that balance, we are going to have to credit the account because like signs add. When we pay the bill and we want to reduce the balance in accounts payable, we will have to debit the account. Reduce the balance in accounts payable with a debit because opposite signs subtract. That's all for this lecture. You may want to print a copy of the rules of debits and credits for your records. Simply click on the link to the worksheet provided directly above this video lecture on the Canvas page. See you next time.